Hello and welcome to our latest episode. This one, things will be a bit different. In the month of August, we had some holidays, much needed holidays, to rest our bodies. And the fire hazard risk was very extreme in Portugal, especially in this region. So we couldn't make a lot in our land regarding reforestation and everything else. So we thought, why not show you the next two big projects that we will start in the upcoming months. Let's go. So, right there, it's an old water dam, and Pedro will show you and explain you how it exists and what we want to do with it. And right next to the water dam you have these terraces, and no better else than João with his expertise to explain the big project that is incoming. So let's see their explanations and the history of this place.
Hello everyone, how are you all doing? Today I'm going to be explaining a little bit about our projects for the next year. So right here we are at the what we call the terraces. So before we intervened, this was a plantation of eucalyptus, a monoculture. And before that, this was actually the terraces of the people that lived in the village. So we're actually trying to recreate what used to be here in the old days.
I am here today to talk to you about a big part of our project that's going to be taking place now in these following months. We're going to be reshaping, improving on these terraces a bit. And what are we going to implement here? We're going to try and implement here a Syntropic agroforest, which is an agricultural system developed by Ernst Gotsch in the late 80s in Brazil, which aims to mimic nature. So to be mainly process-based versus input-based. The main input we're going to have here is labor. We're going to be hard at work here, sweating, to get this working. There are three core principles that this part of the project is going to follow. One of them is to always have some ground cover. Another one of them is to use plant consortiums, plants that work well together and benefit each other's productivity. And the last one is to have an organized system of pruning. One of the big advantages of these systems is that they're highly effective in restoring degraded ecosystems through high production of biomass, which in turn will allow us to increase the amount of organic matter and microbial activity in the soil and attract pollinators, wildlife. One of the big advantages of these systems is that they're very efficient in restoring degraded ecosystems. It's going to produce a lot of biomass. And through the pruning that we're going to be doing, we're going to be returning this to the soil and increasing the amount of organic matter and microbial activity that exists in this, or that doesn't exist in this parcel of land right now. Cavalozinha. These agroforest systems are very good in accelerating and optimizing the natural succession, for which we're going to be using a lot of autochthonous species that are from Portugal. Hopefully we'll try to keep that genetic material as close to home as we can. And as the plants settle in, some are going to die off, some are going to change their function, for example, from producing biomass to producing fruit. But they will organically leave room for the next phases of succession. Also through this work of pruning that we're going to be doing here for the next few years. But after that, it's going to be basically self-sustainable in terms of labor, and it's not going to need as heavy intervention, and it will be here a space that will attract wildlife, serve as refuge, as a food source, and not only for wildlife, but hopefully for us as well.
If you want to help us in reforesting more than 230 hectares of land with indigenous and native forest, you can now do so by becoming a member at our website. Thank you.
Okay, so we're right here at the dam of Silveira. So this was a dam that was constructed in the 80s, and it was for a project of goat. So this dam was built in the 80s, and it wasn't built by us, it was built by other people. And it's badly constructed, it's full of leaks, and it's not retaining water. And it's not retaining water. And it's It's full of leaks and it's not retaining water. So we're gonna rebuild this and we're gonna use it to retain water from rain and from the rivers. And we're gonna use that water for irrigation of the forests and some fields like the terraces that are below of it. And we're gonna also incorporate a lot of aquatic plants and increase the biodiversity of everything as a whole around this whole area. And will also be used for animals to drink water. And we'll be documenting and we'll be documenting the whole process and we'll be sharing with you guys on the YouTube channel.
Why are you digging up holes?
We are taking soil samples to send to the university in Coimbra so they can tell us the soil properties so then we plant accurately. Next one.